गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ बायोलॉजी चैप्टर नंबर सेकंड टिश्यू, दैट इज द सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यू. सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यू, एज द नेम सजेस्ट, इट इज मेड अप ऑफ ओनली वन काइंड ऑफ सेल्स. दीज सिमिलर काइंड्स ऑफ सेल्स दे यूनाइट टूगेदर एंड हैविंग अ स्पेसिफिक फंक्शंस टू परफॉर्म. And that's why these type of cells are known as the simple permanent tissue. These simple permanent tissue, they further divide into parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Each of these three tissue, parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma, have a specific functions to perform in the case of the plant cells. So in today's video, we will discuss about the structure, function of these tissues. Among them, the first is the parenchyma. Parenchyma tissue, the diagram, as you can see on the board, the diagram is showing the round oval cells. The shape of the cells are round and oval. And the tissue is composed of large and thin walled cells. The walls, you can see, it is written also there, thin peripheral layer of cytoplasm. The walls are thin, the cells are large. The cells are generally oval or round in the shape. And these cells are loosely packed. Loosely packed means these, among these cells, the gap is present. They are loosely packed, they are not closely packed. That is, there are intercellular spaces present between them. And these intercellular space, you can see in diagram shown to you by the purple colored chalk. These are the intercellular space which is present in between them. And thin primary cellulose wall is present in these cells. Because they are present in the plant cell, that's why cell wall is the integral part of the plant cell. In this, the large central vacuole is also present. These large central vacuole is having a function of storage, because we know very well, we already studied in the chapter number first, that the vacuoles act as the storeroom of the cell. They are having a function of storage. They maintain the osmoregulation of the cell. They store water, nutrients, ions, waste of the plant cell. So there is a large central vacuole is present. And these cells are living. That's why you can see the nucleus and a vacuole. And the protoplasm is also present.